Good morning, student. Our today's topic is design of knuckle joint. This is the 3D view of a knuckle joint. This portion is called as a fork. This red portion is called as a single eye, and this is the knuckle pin. The white portion is the knuckle pin. This is a collar, and this is a called as a quarter split pin, which is inserted to avoid the dropping of the knuckle pin. So knuckle joint is used to connect two rods in tension, and the some angular misalignment is also compensated by knuckle joints. So this is about the knuckle joint. These are the various parts of the knuckle joint. This is called as a single eye. This is called as a double eye or fork. This is the knuckle pin, and this is the collar, and this is the taper pin. So there is a hole in the knuckle pin as well as holes in the collar. So to avoid the dropping of the knuckle pin, the holes of the collar and the knuckle pin is adjusted, and taper pin is inserted in that to avoid the dropping of the knuckle pin while operation. So this is about the various part of the knuckle joint. This is the cross sectional view. This is the cross sectional view of a knuckle joint. This is the cross sectional front view, and this is the top view of the knuckle joint. In designing of the knuckle joint, we have to find various dimensions. So that dimensions are: D is the rod diameter, D1 is the enlarged diameter of the rod, A is the thickness of the fork end, and B is the thickness of the eye end, and D or DP is the knuckle pin diameter, and D1 is the outer diameter of the collar of the knuckle pin, and DO is the outer diameter of the single eye as well as fork eye. So these are the various dimension we have to find. Here it P is the load to be applied on the joint. So these are two rods, rod A and rod B are connected with the help of knuckle joint. Here this is the split pin. So these are the various notation used in knuckle joint. P is the tensile force acting on the rod, capital D diameter of each rod, capital D1 enlarged diameter of each rod, small d diameter of knuckle pin, DO outside diameter of the eye or fork, A is the thickness of each fork, B is the thickness of eye, D1 is the diameter of pin head, X is the distance of center of the fork radius from the eye, tau is the permissible shear stress for knuckle pin, sigma T is the permissible tensile stress, and sigma CR is the permissible crushing stress. So these are the various notation used in knuckle joint. This is the free body diagram of the various parts of the knuckle joint. This is your double eye or fork. So this is the P load acting on the joint, and these are the reactions at the fork end. This is P/2 and this is P/2. This is single eye. So this is the P load acting on the rod B, and this is the reaction acting at the single eye. These are the forces acting on the knuckle pin. The knuckle pin is divided into three parts. This upper part is in fork end, and this middle part is in single eye, and this bottom portion is in fork end. So these are the forces acting on the knuckle pin. This is P, and this is P/2 and P/2. The This is the free body diagram of an. This is the shear failure of a knuckle pin. So, as we already know that the knuckle pin is divided into three portion. Due to that, there is a chances of shear failure of the knuckle pin, and the shear is double shear. So this is the shear failure of the knuckle pin. Crushing failure of the knuckle pin in the eye. So sometime there may be chances of crushing failure. So in crushing failure, projected contact area of the pin is considered. So D is the diameter of knuckle pin, and this L is the length or thickness of the single eye or double eye. So this is about the crushing failure of the knuckle pin. Then next is tensile or shear failure of the eye. So there may be chances of tensile failure and shear failure of the single eye. So see here, if the single eye is failed in this way, it is called a tensile failure of the single eye. This is the resisting area to avoid the tensile failure. And this is the shear failure of the single eye. So this is the resisting area of the shear failure. So this is about the tensile and shear failure of the eye. Now, this is the problem statement we have to design of a knuckle joint. It is required to design a knuckle joint to connect two rods, circular rods subjected to an axial tensile force of 50 kilonewton. The rods are coaxial and small amount of angular movement between their axes is permissible. So we have to design the knuckle joint for 50 kilonewton load, means 50 into 10 raised to 3 newton. These are the steps to be followed to design the quarter joint. First step is selection of material. Second, selection of factor of safety. 3, calculation of permissible stresses. 4, calculation of dimensions. And 5, dimensional sketch of the knuckle joint. So selection of material. As we know that the knuckle joint is subjected to tensile load. So we have to select the material so that its tensile carrying capacity should be high. So for generally for knuckle joint, we select plain carbon steel having SYT 400 Newton per mm square. Now we have to select the factor of safety. As in this, we have not considered the stress concentration effect. So to compensate this effect of stress concentration, we select higher factor of safety as a FOS is equal to 5. Then calculation of permissible stresses. In this, we have to calculate permissible tensile stress and permissible shear stress. Permissible tensile stress is calculated by sigma t is equal to SYT upon FOS. And after that, calculation of dimension. There is a step-by-step procedure to calculate all dimensions of the knuckle joint. Then there is a fifth step, dimensional sketch of the knuckle joint. So this step number 4 and 5 we see in next slides. So the basic procedure to determine the dimensions of the knuckle joint consists of following step. So step number 4.1, calculate the diameter of each rod. So diameter of rod is denoted by capital D, and we know that the rod is subjected to tensile stress. So sigma T is equal to P by A. This is the basic formula for tensile stress. So putting A as a resisting area, the resisting area is pi by 4 D square. So putting the value of permissible tensile stress sigma T and P as a 50 into 10 raised to 3 Newton, we can calculate diameter of the rod D. Then second step is calculate the enlarged diameter of each rod. So the enlarged diameter of rod is calculated by empirical formula D1 is equal to 1.1D. Now step number 4.3, calculate the dimensions A and B. So dimension A is the thickness of each fork and dimension B is the thickness of single eye. So this dimension is also find with the help of empirical formula. That empirical formula are A is equal to 0.75D and B is equal to 1.25D. Next step is step number 4.4, calculate the diameter of the knuckle pin. So as already discussed that the knuckle pin is subjected to double shear. So we know that the shear stress induced in knuckle pin is P by A, where A is the resisting area. So here A is equal to 2 into pi by 4 D square, where D is the diameter of knuckle pin. This 2 is multiplied because there is a double shear. Knuckle pin is failure in 3 parts, so it is a double shear. So by this formula, we can find diameter of knuckle pin. Then in step number 4.5, calculate dimension DO and DI. DO is the outer diameter of the eye or I. DO is the outer diameter of eye and fork, and D1 is the diameter of pin head. So DO is equal to 2.D and DI is equal to 1.5D. This is the empirical dimensions. Then step number 4.6, check the tensile crushing and shear stresses in the eye. As we find the diameter of diameter DO by empirical formula, so whenever we find any dimension by empirical formula, we have to check that dimension for induced stresses. So in this step, we have to calculate sigma T induced, sigma CR induced, and tau induced. So these are the basic basic formula for sigma T, sigma CR and tau. Now we have to put our calculated dimension in this formula. So sigma T induced is equal to P divided by B in bracket DO minus D. So DO is the outer diameter of the eye and D is the diameter of knuckle pin and B is the thickness of the eye, single eye. So putting all these dimension, we can find sigma T induced. So that this sigma T induced should be less than sigma T permissible to avoid the failure of the single eye in tension. Similarly, we can calculate sigma CR induced and tau induced. So this sigma CR induced should be less than sigma CR permissible and this tau induced should be less than sigma this tau induced should be less than tau permissible to avoid the joint in crushing as well as shear failure. Similarly, we can find the induced tensile, induced crushing and induced shear stress in the double eye or fork. So here 2 is multiplied for double and A is the distance of the fork end. So in this way, we have to find sigma T induced, sigma CR induced and tau induced. And this induced stresses should be less than permissible stresses. This is the final step. After finding the various dimension, we have to draw 3 views of the knuckle joint. So this is the sectional front view. This is top view. And this is the side view. So in this way, we have designed the knuckle joint. So thank you, everyone.